Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install Spring Tool Suite, that is STS, on a Windows operating system. And then I am also going to show you a simple Spring Boot program that you are going to run on our Spring Tool Suite. So do watch the video till the end, and if you have any issues, please do comment in our comment sections. I am always there to help you. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install STS, you need to first simply go to favorite browser. And in that this bar, into just simply search with Spring Tool Suite download, and it's going to show you the spring.io as your first search result. So here you need to just simply click on Tools Spring, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Spring. And here you can see we have Spring Tools version 4 is available to download. So all you need to do is you need to just simply scroll down, and here you can see that our Spring Tool 4 is available for Linux, macOS and Windows. So I'm going to show it for Windows, and so I'm going to click on that. If you are into Linux, macOS, then you need to proceed with this link, and I'll just simply scroll down, and I'm also going to show you that our Spring Tool 4 for Visual Studio Code is also available. So in order to download, you need to click on this, and also Spring Tool 4 for Thea is also available. So if you are into, you know, all those things, you can easily download all that. So here I am downloading it for Windows. Let's minimize our browser and go back to download directory. So it is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 582 MB. Okay, so it's quite big enough, so you need to have that much bandwidth. So just wanted to remind you that. So first you need to extract it. So for that, just simply double click on it, and it will going to, you know, start extracting our STS. So here you can see the extraction process has rightly began. So after, you know, 100%, it's going to extract over here. So let's wait for some time. So you can see that our STS is rightly downloaded over here. So let's open the folder, and here you can see all files and folders are rightly over here. So here, this is our product, that is the Spring Tool Suite 4. So you need to just simply double click on the exe, and you can see that our STS 4 is rightly open. So let's minimize our download directory. So our STS is rightly launched, and it is asking what workspace you'd like to give. So on our C drive in document directory, they're going to create this folder. I'm going to, you know, shorten this. So I'm going to keep it only till, you know, STS4, right? And I'm just going to click on launch, and you can see that our STS4 is rightly launched over here. So let's maximize it. So this is the interface of our Spring STS tool. So it is very similar to Eclipse IDE. So on this channel, I have already made a video on Eclipse. So it's pretty much same as STS. So here under Package Explorer, you can see you can create a Java project. You can also create a new, you know, Spring Starter project and all. So you can click on this and you can start your project, or else the best method is go to File, New, and here you can, you know, create your projects. So I am going to, you know, going to click on Spring Starter Project, right? Because we use STS for Spring project only. And here you can see this is our service URL all rightly set. So let's give a project name as, you know, Hello Spring, and just going to, you know, type is Groovy rightly set. So jar file language is Java, and our latest LTS version of Java, that is 17, is also selected. So group, let's give, you know, change it the example to, you know, Hello Spring, right? So artifact name is also rightly set. Version number for now it's 001 because we are just starting. Okay, and description you can give anything. So right now it's set it as demo project for Spring Boot, and package name you can change it to, you know, remove this example, and you can give, let's say, demo dot our project name, which is Spring Hello. Okay, so this is be small. So all other things are fine. Just simply click on next, and this is the most important part. So here all dependencies you need to, you know, select from here. So our latest version of Spring Boot version is version 3.0.2. if you are into some older version like 2, then you need to choose from here. I'll going to choose 3, and this is the most important area. So here you need to choose all dependencies. So let's say your project will need, you know, this JDBC Spring data. So for that you need to choose this. If you need JDBC API, so whatever dependencies you need to choose all that. Okay, if you need, you know, MySQL driver, so you can just simply select that and it's going to automatically, you know, get that dependency for you, because you are using STS. You don't need to fetch the files and all from browser and, you know, manually set that in our class path. Everything they're going to do, right? So you can choose anything from here. If you are developing some web-based application, so Spring Web and all, you can choose from here. Everything you can do, right? If you are doing some testing, so for testing related packages and all, you can easily get it from here, right? So it all totally depends upon you, whatever project you are going to create, right? So everything is fine. You need to just simply click on finish, and you can see it's going to start fetching all the files from internet, and it automatically going to set our project. So here just 20% done. It will take some time. You need to have active internet connection. That's the most important part. So let's give some time to finish this, and then I am again going to come back. So welcome back, guys. So you can see our project is rightly set up now. All packages and all are downloaded. Just simply expand this and you can see all files over here. So this is our, you know, main src folder. So this is the package we have created, remember, comdemo.hellospring, rightly shown over here. So if you expand this, you can see our Java class, and here is our main method. So let's double click on our Java class, and you can see it has rightly launched over here. And here if you go, you can see here is our resources. So this is our template, static and all, and here is our test. So for test as well, we have this sample test class rightly created over here. So if you open this, you can see this test class rightly created, and we have this annotation called test and annotation called Spring Boot test and all. So for testing, you need to use this class, and for our main controller and all, you are supposed to use this, our this main Java project that we have created, that is our this package, Hello Spring. So here only under this package, you're going to, you know, keep on creating your classes, basically controllers and all. And you can see this annotation called Spring Boot application, and here is our main method. So this Spring STS tool will also going to provide Tomcat, so you don't need to worry about any, you know, server side software. So it will also automatically going to come up with Tomcat server. So that's basically all about this video. I don't want to make this video too long. If you need more tutorials, please do comment in your comment sections. I'll be happy to make more tutorials about Spring STS tool. In this channel, you'll also get a tutorial on, you know, how we can manually set the class and everything to create a Spring application. So I have made that video on Eclipse. So if you want to watch that, you can also watch that video. I'll be putting the link in the description. So there I have created this controller and all. I'm passing the messages and all. So you can watch that video if you need. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like the video, please give it a like, and also please do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.